Welcome to qualifying here in Interlagos as the cars are readying up for what's likely to be a very important session. Looking at this field today, Ant, do you think we're going to see anyone take a chance, maybe run the harder of the available compounds and save some of the grippy tyres for the race tomorrow?
Well, I'd be surprised in all honesty. It's only the front runners that really have the pace to get away with that. And even then, at the end of the day, it's a big risk. Track position is the most important thing, and it's rarely worth sacrificing for a slightly more optimal strategy in the race, so I doubt we're going to see anyone trying it. I have been wrong before, though. We certainly do see some risky decisions every now and then, and it's a gamble that's sometimes worth taking. But if it were me in the car, I would want to be on the fastest tyre for my qualifying lap, without a doubt.
We don't think you'll have any trouble getting into the next session.
Welcome to today's championship race, which is shaping up to be a real nail-biter. It's an unusual anti-clockwise race here at Interlagos, where the Sao Paulo locals are packed into the grandstands at each of the 15 corners around this classic 2.7-mile circuit. Two very fast sections bookend the famous and highly technical Sector 2, where getting a good run out of Junsao into one of the two DRS zones will be the key to any overtaking prospects today. A tough race in store then for our drivers today, so tell me, Anthony Davidson, what will you be looking out for as the cars make their way down into Turn 1?
Well, first of all, let's hope that everyone's well behaved and we can have a nice incident-free start. That initial release is going to be the most interesting thing. And the clean side of the grid will be better rubbered in, so keep an eye out for cars over there potentially making their way through.
Well then, after an exciting qualifying session yesterday, let's take a look at how the cars line up. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Verstappen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Ocon, Perez, Magnussen, Sainz, and Nico Hülkenberg, Massa, Grosjean, Daniel Kvyat, and Alonso, Stroll, Palmer, Stoffel Van Dorn, and Pascal Wehrlein, Ericsson, and Sebastian Vettel starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Championship, so relax and enjoy this race.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Valtteri...
OK, be wary of the cars ahead braking suddenly into one. We could ruin our race if we hit them. Good luck.
Thank you.
is 1.8 seconds. The gap to the car behind is 2.7 seconds. We're considering switching to an alternate strategy. Do you want to change or stick to plan A? Thank you. minutes, Kimi is pitting. We're running in excess of fuel. Mix 3 is there if you need it. Mix 3. Strategy complete. See these tires through to the end now. is 2.6 seconds. Hülkenberg ahead. Okay, gap ahead is 2.6 seconds. We're gaining by around 2/10 per lap. They're on old super softs. We think they've got one more stop. The time last lap was a 1:13.3. is 2.4 seconds. clear. We'll be right back. tanks of fuel remaining. Okay, gap ahead is 13.1 seconds. over and bring it home.
Brilliant stuff from Mercedes today. That's another historic win. And Anthony Davidson, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
Well, I think the track conditions just really suited their car today. Wind, track temperature, you name it. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature. So the more easily you can keep them there, the better your race tends to go. And that's exactly what happened. Their car just looks so comfortable out there.
So as I say that, we can see the drivers coming out now to collect their trophies. It's yet more silverware to take back to their base in Brackley after another excellent Grand Prix. It wasn't the best weekend for our championship leader, and their advantage at the top has been reduced. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Sebastian Vettel. He was a class above today, just an absolute pleasure to watch.
The constructors' title may already be decided, but so then, Ferrari have now moved out of sight and out of reach. It's another triumph for the Italian team as they claim the World Constructors' Championship. After all that excitement, it's time for a lie down, I think. Thanks for joining us, and goodbye until the next race.